Welcome to JORDANVALVE maintenance videos. This is a Mark 80 repair video. These are the tools you will need: two open-ended wrenches, a torque wrench, an Allen wrench, a screwdriver, number 4 grease or equivalent, solvent, 3-in-1 oil, and antisease. These are the items included in your repair kit: plate, disc guide, disc, packing spring, packing retainer, packing, stem, the lock nut will come attached to the stem, and the disc pen. Note the scribed arrow on the side of the valve body and cap. Secure the body outlet flat in a vise. Remove the cap screws and two nuts and lift the cap straight up. Before removing, check the disc for a stamped arrow. This arrow points to the left on the body. Remove the disc guide and the disc. Place the valve disc on the bench with the lapped surface facing up. Protect the lap surface on both sides of the disc guide. Improper handling of seats will result in leakage or poor control. It is imperative that the disc pin not be rotated when disassembling, cleaning, or reassembling, since this affects the stroke adjustment. Lightly tap on the body to remove the plate. Invert the body, let the valve plate drop out into your hand, and place it on the bench with the lapped surface facing up. Now you are ready to reassemble the seats. Place the plate with antisease in the body, lap surface facing the cap. The index pin hole should be on the same side as the arrow on the body. Align the disc pin so that it is centered in the body bore through the center slot in the valve plate. Place the disc on the plate, engaging the index pin. If there is an arrow on the disc, it should point towards the index pin hole on the plate. Place the disc guide onto the plate, engaging the disc pin. Rotate the assembly slightly until the slot opening and the disc are parallel to the opening in the plate and perpendicular to the stem. Stroking the valve will aid in this alignment. Align the arrow on the cap with the arrow on the body and place the cap over the two studs in the body. Install the nuts and cap screws. Tighten uniformly. Now torque the nuts and cap screws. See the Mark 80 I&M for torque requirements and tightening procedures. Loosen stem connector nut and bolt. And remove connector. Back out the 4 Allen head yoke screws, 1/2 inch to 2 inch sizes, which will allow the body to be separated from the yoke. Remove the packing flange nuts and the packing flange. Loosen the stem lock nut and rotate the disc pin, pulling the valve stem upward while doing so. When pulling the stem completely out of the body, you will remove most of the packing assembly also. The remaining parts of the packing assembly can be fished out with a small screwdriver. Clean the packing bore with solvent. Blow dry, which is done off camera. Turn the valve over. Clean the body with solvent. Blow dry, which is done off camera. And apply antisease. The disc pin may be removed through the body bore. Reassemble the disc pin, stem, and lock nut in the valve body as they originally were. Replace the packing spring and packing retainer in the packing bore. Reassemble the new packing on the stem with lubricant, the open part of the arrow downward. There will be a flat on the bottom and the top. Place the packing follower on top of the packing. Gently push the packing into the packing bore and place the packing flange on the stem and over the packing studs. Put on the flange nuts and tighten them partially. At this point, it is recommended that you gently move the stem up and down 3 or 4 times to align the assembly. Tighten the flange nuts until the packing follower bottoms out on the top of the body. If you have any questions about this video, please email us or call us at the phone number listed on the screen. Also, be sure to visit our website, www.jordanvalve.com, for more information. Thanks for watching.